Hello, a very good evening. So today I'll be talking about the most awaited or most discussed event, rather, not awaited, it's a discussed event, that is the solar eclipse that is happening on 4th of December, that is day after tomorrow. So this is actually the last solar eclipse of the year to 2021, and it's occurring on Saturday on Shani Amavasya. And it is a Ketu Grasta Surya Grahana. What do I mean by this? Ketu is afflicting planet Sun. Sun is considered as a planet in astrology. So this grahana is a Surya Grahana or solar eclipse. It's a total solar eclipse. Now, scientifically speaking, whenever the moon comes in between the sun and the earth, and all of them, are in a straight line, all the three are in a straight line, a shadow of the moon is cast on the people. Cast so that the people on the earth cannot see the sun partially or completely. All right. So this is called as solar eclipse. This time it is completely getting obstructed. Where it is seen is a different thing, but the phenomena that's happening is it's a total solar eclipse. Eclipse is a very common occurring. In a year, there are at least four eclipses, two solar eclipses and two lunar eclipses. Maximum we can have five eclipses in a year. Then why only certain eclipses are spoken so widely, and why they are given so much importance? There is a reason for that. Actually, where the eclipse occurs, like in which zodiac sign it occurs, is very important. And also, what are the other planets that are getting involved in the in this phenomena? Means, are they conjuncting, or how they are interrelated and how they are going to bring the result. So that is why this is discussed. One more point, what you have to remember is all the solar eclipse and lunar eclipse, whenever solar eclipse happens, either 15 days prior or 15 days after, there is a lunar eclipse. Already 2 weeks back, we had about a fortnight back, I mean, we had Chandra Grahan also that occurred in with Rahu and Chandra. Now the energies are set in. So those energies are operating, and after that lunar eclipse, many things have started happening, unnecessary rains and flooding, and now the new break of again COVID mutant. So all these are phenomena that are activated. Now this is a cycle is going to complete. So let us see in detail what happens, what is the effect of this solar eclipse. Before proceeding with this, I would like to tell one more thing. Effects of solar eclipse are more pronounced than lunar eclipse. Lunar eclipse affects, of course, it affects water, it affects mind, because in astrology we say Chandrama Manaso Jataha. So moon controls our mind. So lot of disturbances and lot of stuff happen with moon. But Surya or Sun is called our Atma, who is the soul, reason for our existence. If you think in a in nature or in scientific way, without sun there can be no life on this earth. As long as sun is burning in the sky or sun is there, he's providing his light energy, we all are alive and we are all able to do. We means I include everything, like all animals and plants and humans and whatever, whatever. So the life exists only because of sun. So sun is called Atma. Soul is actually not an equivalent word for Atma, so I don't call sun soul. Sun is Atma only. So that is the whole purpose of our existence. Now, affliction to sun means naturally affliction to our Atma. It means in every way we get affected by this. Now, sun in astrology is considered as king or raja and or a leader. Or a ruling government or authority figure, popular figures, leader of masses. If you think in the family context, it is a father or a guardian or a grandfather, whoever is looking after the house, and who is a father or a figurehead of your family, that is son. All right. So how actually people study this eclipse? See, actually eclipse has got three phases. One is the beginning, the peak, and the end. All right, there are some people who cast a horoscope for the solar eclipse to understand how the things, energies are going to work when it is beginning. And some believe that they have to take it when it is peak. There are yet another school of thought. They say that when the tithi enters, when that particular tithi enters, because solar eclipse generally happens on new moon day, that is Amavasya. So as soon as the Amavasya tithi enters, we have to cast a horoscope. That is what some say. But for my studies, I have cast the horoscope because we want to study the effects and how it's going to affect and what are the planets involved and all that completely. So I have taken the timing as when it is peak. So let us understand when this is going to begin, when this Amavasya is going to enter. Actually, Amavasya begins on the previous day. That is, tomorrow the Amavasya is going to begin in the evening around 4:56 p.m. All right? And it ends in on 4th afternoon. After the Grahan gets over, that Amavasya also ends. And where it is occurring now? It is occurring in Scorpio. Scorpio is a 8th sign in Kala Purusha's Kundali. Those who know a little bit of astrology can understand. 8th house indicates mystery, hidden agenda, and also death. It's called house of death, house of trouble, and sudden gains and sudden trouble, accidents, everything bad and good associated, something which is very mysterious is associated with 8th house. And it is occurring in Vrishchika or 8th house of Kala Purusha or the sign of Scorpio in a nakshatra called Jyeshtha. Now, this Jyeshtha nakshatra is ruled by Mercury, planet Mercury. Jyeshtha means elder. Now, if I consider family, it's not always an elder brother, Jyeshtha Bhrata or Jyeshtha Pita. It's not like that. Just anybody who is a figurehead who is taking care of you. So in a family, again, as I told you, the family figurehead who looks after the entire family. If it's a village ka mukhya becomes a Jyeshtha. If you take a country, then the prime minister or president, whoever is powerfully ruling us, they become so. That is how, again, the leadership comes over. It's happening in that. And when is it going to begin? It's going to begin at 10:59 a.m. on 4th. Okay. And peak is at 1:03. In the afternoon. So the horoscope I have taken for study is 1:05. It means 5 minutes past 1 p.m. Then when is it going to get over? So that's going to get over at 3:07 p.m. So that is called as Moksha Kala. Now what you have to do, I'll tell it quickly here only. As soon as the Grahana begins, before the Grahana begins only, at least 1 hour earlier, you eat something, whatever you want to eat. Again, this rule doesn't apply to very small children, pregnant women, or people with illnesses or very elderly people. They are exempted, but eat something very light. Don't eat, because cosmic forces are in a different mode. So don't eat too much or too heavy stuff and all that for your own good health. So it begins at 10:59, and throughout the Grahana period, chant whatever mantras you believe in. It's not that you may not be a Hindu, so you may not understand your mantras. Pray to your own God. That's okay. Connect with the higher force is the message over here. And for all the Hindus who believe in astrology, who believe in the thing, you have to chant Suryaka mantra. You have to chant Ketu mantra, because Ketu and Surya are causing this Grahana. All right. Please, watch my previous video, which I had made on eclipses. I have given all the mantras also over there. So you can chant Ketu mantra. If you don't know the mantras and all that, actually sun. So Japa Kusuma Sankasham Kashapeyam Mahaditim Tamurim Sarva Papagnam Pranatosmi Divakaram. If you don't know this, simple one you can chant. Adityam Bhaskaram Bhanum Ravim Suryam Divakaram Shadetani Pathen Nityam Sarva Dosha Hareshu. If you can't do this also, fine. You can just say Om Sam Suryaya Namaha. Okay, or Ram Ravaye Namaha. This you can do. And for Ketu, again, Ketu mantra you can chant. I have given it in my previous video. Otherwise, this video will become very large. So I'm not again repeating those things. Now, where it is seen? Moksha Kalme, okay, when the eclipse get over, please take bath. And during the Grahana period and all that, it's very good for donating something and chanting mantras. But don't go to temple. After the moksha is over, the Grahana is over, you take bath and then you can do the worship, or you can go to temple, whatever you want. Now, where it is seen? It is partly seen in South Africa, South America, Pacific, then Indian Ocean, then Atlantic, and fully visible in Antarctica. Antarctica, you can see it completely, the beautifully entire dark surface, you could see that. So, and all these things, what I mentioned, wherever it is partly visible or fully visible, they will have the effects of this grahana from 75 to 100%. All right. It is not visible in India at all, but it's a natural occurrence. It is happening. It is definitely going to have some effect on us. So 25 to 50% of effects are definitely seen on this in India. So we can't say, okay, it's not seen, so let me not do anything. If it is not seen, we don't have to observe the Ved Kal, what we say, the previous before setting that period, you don't have to worry. But whenever the grahana occurs, whatever I said, you could do that. In fact, earlier, all our sages and Rishi Munis and all that, they were able to calculate based on the planetary positions, when is the grahana occurring and all that, with the help of something called as Kurma Chakra also, they used to calculate where exactly, in which direction the more it will be affected, because they didn't have NASA, they didn't have any, computer aided calculations at that time. So that is how they used to do. Anyway, all right. Now, Jyeshtha rules western direction. Jyeshtha is ruled by Buddha, actually, the nakshatra, but the direction given to Jyeshtha is western direction. So the ill effects are more pronounced in the western countries. That's why I took name of all these countries. Now, if we talk of India, all the western part of India, what are the western part of India? First thing is our Maharashtra, then Gujarat, then maybe Goa, so West Bengal. So whatever comes on the west side of India will be affected. And if we talk of Mumbai in particular, all the western suburbs Borivali, Andheri, Dahisar, Mira Road, and all that stuff, that will suffer a lot, in the sense the effects are seen more. Now, when we talk of zodiac signs, who is going to have a more pronounced effect and who are having least affected? Let's see. So, those who are having moon sign, okay, that is Rashi I'm talking about, Chandra Rashi. So Mithuna, Tula, Kumbha. It means Gemini, then Libra, and then Aquarius. These people are lucky. They will have only 0 to 25% of the effects of this grahana. Next is Mesha, Simha, Dhanu. It means Aries, then Leo, and then Sagittarius. These people will have 25 to 50%. Then comes Rishabha, Kanya, and Makara. It means Taurus, then Virgo, and Capricorn. These people will have 50 to 75% of effect. And the last lot, Karka, Vrishchika, and Mina. All these are Jalatattva Rashis. So Karka, Vrishchika, Mina, it means the Cancer, then Scorpio, and Pisces. These people are going to have the ill effects right from 75% to 100%, so they need to take care. Now, let us understand, I just mentioned that ruler and all that. What could happen? What could be the effects of this grahana? Let's talk about it. First thing is all ruling party, people in power, then authorities, and then your president and prime minister, or any leader of masses, you can say, or a very popular actor. They may suffer attack on life. I'm not talking only of India. This is in general for the entire world. Okay. So as I explained earlier, the effect depends upon to what degree the grahana is occurring and what percent of effect we are getting. But it's a universal phenomena. India is included. I'm not excluding India, but throughout the world. So there may be a threat to life of leaders or politicians or whatever, or there may be an attack on their life. There is also a possibility of mysterious death, which may lead to kind of unrest or among the followers, any popular personality dies and mysteriously, there's a lot of unrest in people. It may lead to a lot of disturbances and disrupting situation. That is one thing. See, moon in Scorpio is already debilitated. Scorpio is Jalatattva Rashi. Moon Moon is, I said, Chandrama Manaso Jata, in the eighth house, in the house of death, if you keep your mind, what happens? Constantly you think negative, right? You can't think, you can't be very happy and think about nice things. And plus, Ketu is also there in Vrishchika. So Ketu is a Moksha Karaka. So he pulls you towards spirituality. Now, what do we mean by Moksha Karaka? So spirituality means Ketu will not say, hey, come on guys, like leave everything and pray to God. It's not like that. Moksha Karaka means, why we call Scorpio as the house of death? Death is not always to be taken in a negative sense. When something happening ends, then only something new can emerge out. So that's what is going to happen as a result of this eclipse, because of the energy is what I am talking about. So Ketu is also associated with technology, intelligence, and you know, and he will promote something. And especially now in this period after this Grahana, when the energies are fully activated, a lot of things will emerge out on the platform of AI, artificial intelligence, and machine learning, and gadgets, and technical stuff. So a lot of good things will come. But also there will be end of so many things. Scorpio is a hidden house, I said. So all sab ka kala kartut bahar aa jayega, you know, like all the scams will come out. If you are escaping all these years, making loads of money, nobody caught you, or you were lucky to do that. But now it is not the time. You have to pay for what you have done. You know, that kind of a situation will come. And there also is like, you know, possibility that now we may have very sour relation with our neighboring countries, like Pakistan and China. Especially with China, there may be a kind of warlike situation, that too through the waterways, because again it's in the water sign. Moon also is associated. It might lead to that. And then, you know, there may be disturbances in the space also. Now, what do you mean by disturbance in space? How it is going to affect Earth? See, sudden, you know, like fall of meteors, it could be, or collision of things in the space. So that also is indicated by this Grahana. And since Buddha is associated, now who is Buddha or Mercury? Mercury, Buddha is a Buddhi Karaka. So he is your intellect. He is your, like, you know, capacity to learn. He is your youthfulness. He is, Mercury is called Rajkumara, the young boy, like, you know, so Mercury has the habit of transforming the energies of the planet, whatever he is associated with. Put Mercury with, you know, like Shani, he will pick up some qualities of Shani. Put him with Rahu, he will pick up, because he's like a small child. Children, you know, like get influenced very easily. That is the thing of Buddha. So since Buddha is involved over here, what happens is Buddha also, you know, represents commerce. Okay, commerce, or, you know, like accounting and sales and whatever things. So things are going to actually, you know, shortage will be created, whether it's artificial or it's a real shortage. We have to wait and watch. And there'll be a lot of inflation worldwide. And there will be, like, you know, commodity crisis in the entire world. That is one thing. And next day after the eclipse, Mars, planet Mars, he is a fiery planet. And Mars is like, who is Mars? You know, he is a Senapati. He is your commander-in-chief. So he's always willing to fight. And he doesn't know how to say the things diplomatically or how to do it. Buddha can do it, but Mars cannot do. You know, like danda or do tukda, that kind of a thing. Mars has got the energies. So Mars is actually going to enter his own sign Scorpio next day. So he will also conjunct with all the planets. Now, why this Grahana is so discussed is we have five planets conjuncting. Actually, four planets are already there when we are having, when this Grahana is occurring. That is Sun and Moon, because it's Amavasya, they are together. And Ketu and Mercury are there. Ketu is there to create Grahana, and Mercury is also there. Already four planets are there. Now, one day after Grahana, on the 5th, Mars also is entering into the field. So the combined energy, and this Grahana effect is going to be there for next 6 months, till the next Grahana occurs. I'll be talking about that. So, because of all this, it is in so much of discussion. And because, you know, like Buddha is involved, it may people also may develop skin problems, especially these Jalatattva Rashis. Karkad and Vrishchika and Meen Rashi. So they got to be very careful and about their hygiene and everything. So they may suddenly boils may erupt on the skin, skin rashes or some kind of skin thing that can occur to them. And now sun is, you know, light. Sun is the one who dispels darkness and leads us in the light. So when sun is involved in the eighth house of mystery, and even the grahana is happening over there, the energy explodes. So what do you think will happen over there? So all the hidden activities will surface. Like it could be drug mafia, or it could be anything, like, you know, any illegal trafficking, or anything can surface. And Ketu and Mars are also promoting this kind of a stuff. So it will be lot of things will be unearthed and they will come to surface. And cyber crime also is going to increase as Mercury and Mars are involved. Ketu is also involved over there. So it could be a financial fraud, or it could be stalking, it could be phishing, it could be sextortion, anything, like all kind of cyber crime is going to increase in this period next 6 months. And ugly face of our readers and rulers and celebrities may be exposed. And Saturn will help them in getting proper justice. It means now no more parda for whatever you do. You will be exposed and you will be punished. And Saturn says now enough is enough and I'm going to do the needful. Now Ketu and Moon will be in Anuradha Nakshatra. Where, So what is happening is Chandrama, I said, he's a Manasujataha. Chandrama is our mind. Ketu is creating confusion over there. So it will be a general period of confusion. Everything happens, but unnecessarily people may start doubting, oh, it will happen or not, and what is going to happen, what's going to happen to my job, and is this friend genuine to me, is my relationship working properly, is my boss hostile and nasty, is he going to check me out of job, or, you know, is my employee going to revolt against me. So unnecessary fears will start, clogging our minds. In general, I'm talking about the entire world. So now, this is a general thing, but if your Rashi is Scorpio, or if your Lagna is Scorpio, Ascendant is Scorpio, if you have in any Rashi or any Lagna, if you have a Moon closer to Ketu in your natal chart, and if we are going through Ketu Dasha or Ketu Antar Dasha, or if you're, you know, these Moon ka Antar Dasha or Moon ka Dasha, and these affect the more all these people will be affected more and more. Ketu is closely conjuncting with Moon. So I mentioned Moon Dasha and Ketu Dasha. So lot of things. So there would be a panic and fear and a dip in confidence and anxiety and some exceptional paranormal phenomena also can occur. So see, paranormal phenomena, those who believe in the ghosts and all that is one thing apart. Paranormal phenomena also means your mind completely not in control. All the schizophrenics may, their disease may get flared up. Lunatics may really suffer a lot. Ordinary people also may get into depression. So all these kind of things are predicted by this. And Corona is coming back with vengeance. Already it has made its surface, the 50th mutated version they are telling. And already it has made its surface. This is going to be more dangerous than the previous one, that is COVID, that surfaced in COVID-19, that surfaced in 20. Okay. So again, you may feel like, you know, why, I'm talking only the negative like that. It's not that. It is only to help all of us to cope up with the situation. So what are we going to do to ward off the ill effect? If we talk of Corona, please don't take it lightly. Don't think that, okay, I have got double dose of a vaccination, nothing will happen to me. That's a foolish thing. Please don't. Because the mutated virus already, their medical reports are telling that it's surpassing your two doses of vaccination. Still, you are getting affected. So, you know, use all the precautions. See, one, like our government is doing a lot for us, but we need to cooperate at the grassroots level. We all should become responsible citizens. We can't go on blaming our leaders and, government. They are doing their bit. We have to do. So don't unnecessarily walk out of the home and don't attend the functions. So everything can wait. If you are alive, you can celebrate anything later. So have that clear-cut understanding. Now, I told about all the Scorpio Lagna and all that. How do those people cope up? The best way during this is, the remedy for this is, chant for the next 6 months, be completely having devotion to Hanumanji. Hanumanji and Shivji can protect you. So you can chant Shiva Chalisa, you can chant Hanuman Chalisa. There is a beautiful stotra called as Vadvanal Stotra, which was composed by Vibhishan. So you could say that Vadvanal Stotra, that's also very good. Or Om Namah Shivaya, if you don't know anything, least is Om Namah Shivaya. Every Monday, every day if you do Abhishek to Shiva, thoda jal leke, thoda doodh leke, water and this, that is excellent. If you can't do that, at least do it on Mondays. And have devotion to any of the guru you believe in. Okay, so all like prayers and these things really help. There is definitely something called as God, which is a more pronounced energy, which always protects us. However modern we may become, however we claim we know everything, but ultimately, one thing we all need to remember is there is some force that governs us, some force that has created us and this universe. So how long this effect is going to last is, next 2 months are going to be really, really troublesome as far as the corona is concerned, as the other things also what I've discussed are concerned. But the effect will be there till 30th April 2022. Now, why I'm talking this date is, this is the next solar eclipse. Till next solar eclipse occurs, this is going to be the, all the effects will be seen. Interestingly, next year's eclipse ka chain is beginning with solar eclipse, not with lunar eclipse. After this 30th April 2022, then the things will start slowly settling down and we hope to return to normalcy. Now, quickly, I will take you through the horoscope, and if I show you, it will be completely ultra. You won't be able to see it. So what I will do is, I will post it at the end of the video so that all of you can go through. Currently, I will explain what this means. Actually, I have cast this horoscope for 4/12/21, that is day after tomorrow for horoscope, and 1:05 is the time I have taken. It comes Kumbh Lagna ka Kundali, ascendant is Aquarius. Now just see the things here, how, why it is such an important eclipse. See, in the Lagna, we have Jupiter and Neptune. I'm not talking anything about Neptune, I'm talking about Jupiter. Jupiter is in the nakshatra of Mangala, Dhanishta. Understand? In Kumbh Rashi. So what happens? So he is also indirectly involved because Mars is going to be in the house of eclipse. So Jupiter ka involvement aa gaya. And if you see the placement, you know, Kendra Sthana of Jupiter, 10th house is a Kendra Sthana for Jupiter ascendant. In the 10th house of this Kundali, the entire eclipse is happening. So in that way also Jupiter is involved. Next we talk about Rahu. Now you may say Rahu is 180 degrees away, why are you taking? But when you are 180 degrees away, complete vision, you are completely aspecting or looking at the next house. That is one thing. But where is Rahu? Rahu is in Rishabh Rashi, that is Taurus. And he is in a star called Kritika. Kritika is ruled by Ravi. Ravi is, that is your Surya. So that Surya himself is involved in Grahana. So Rahu is indirectly involved in that. All right. Now, if we talk of Saturn, Saturn is in Makara Rashi, that is the 12th house. 12th house is a house of expenses and all that. Why I said everything is going to come to surface, that is because of Saturn. He'll make you work hard and he will, if you are genuinely good, he will give good results. Otherwise, he will show you your place. So Saturn is in Nakshatra called Shravana. Shravana is ruled by Moon. So Moon is directly involved in the eclipse. It's so interesting. And then Venus is in the Dhanus Rashi, that is in 11th house of this horoscope. And Venus is in a star called Uttarashada, which is ruled by Sun. Sun himself is involved in it. So Venus also indirectly got involved over here. And Moon, as I said, Moon is in Jeshta. Okay, Jeshta is Budha Nakshatra, Buddha. And Buddha himself, Mercury himself is in Jeshta, and he is also in the eclipse ka house. Sun is also in Jeshta, so Sun and Buddha ka Yuti came there. And Ketu is in Anuradha. Ketu is in Anuradha. Anuradha is ruled by Saturn. So if you observe this entire thing, And Mars himself currently, for 2 days, today and tomorrow, he will be in Vishakha, which is Guru's Nakshatra. That's a Jupiter, ruled by Jupiter. Now, Mars is going to immediately move into the next house. So, all these planets are completely involved. And another interesting thing, what will happen, you know, on 5th, when Mars also moves with Ketu, there is a perfect Kala Sarpa Yoga that is pronounced over here. Okay, so that is the situation. So for next 1 month, 15 days to 1 month, you need to be very, very careful till all these planets slowly start moving out. Because Buddha is fast moving, and then Mercury is fast moving, and Sun, Moon also is fast moving. So they start moving out, then the situation will start easing. But 1 month, you need to be very careful, and 6 months is the time period what I would give. So, I mean, you know, viewers, this is my interpretation. Actually, I was not getting time, but a lot of requests started coming in for making video for this eclipse, because I had also predicted for the previous eclipse in 2020, and a lot of viewers liked, and I got very positive feedback. So people were keen on making, that's why I thought of making this video. Sorry, I got late because of my own professional commitments. I was not getting time, that's it. Otherwise, I love to share my knowledge. So please post your doubts or comments. I'll try my best to answer also. So thank you very much. God bless. But don't get scared about the eclipse. As I told, this is a natural phenomena. If we are good, and if our character is good, and if we are on the right path, and if we're not doing anything that is really, you know, harmful to others, then, you know, forces will protect us. But you should know how to be prepared. See, if corona is going to be worse than the earlier version, we all need to take care. We can't change, or, you know, by sitting and chanting at home, you can't make the corona run away. But it will give you power to protect yourself, and, you know, buddhi to act judiciously. So that is what the eclipse is all about. So Om Namah Shivaya ka jap also really, really helps. Okay, thank you very much.